Hello and welcome to the Articy Draft Importer for Unreal tutorial series. During this series, we will take a look at how to access imported Articy data within Unreal Engine 5, with the goal of setting up a simple dialog system to display branching dialog in a custom dialog UI. The Articy Draft Importer for Unreal takes care of getting all the data you want from Articy into the game engine. In Unreal, we will use the Articy Flow Player component, which does a lot of work in the background and takes care of the flow traversal, among other things. However, which data to access and how to display that data in our project is totally on us. That means we will spend some time inside Unreal's Blueprint Editor. Good news though, for the scope of this tutorial, there's no C++ coding required. We will start out with a small Unreal project and step by step update it to a point where we can trigger and display the branching dialog we imported from Articy. Depending on your personal project, you can then go with the same approach or at least use it as a basis you can further modify to your needs. The Articy to Unreal workflow we are going to set up will make life easier for writers and designers, as they can add or edit content in Articy and easily monitor and test this content in the Unreal project. You can follow along this course on YouTube in video form. If you prefer the written word, all lessons will also be available in the form of blog posts. A link to the blog can be found in the video description. In this first lesson, we will take a look at the Unreal project we are going to use as the basis for the series. Then, we will install the importer from the marketplace. Last but not least, we will take a look at the project in Articy Draft and do an export to Unreal. In case you do not have an Articy Draft license yet and just want to see what is possible, you can use Articy Draft 3 free to check out the Articy project and make exports to Unreal. Register, download, and off you go. The link is in the video description. You can download the course material if you want to follow along or if you want to be able to take your time to check out something in detail. The package includes the Unreal project in two variants, a base project, which we will take a look at in a minute, and the complete project as it will look like at the end of the series, as well as the corresponding Articy Draft project. Important side note, if you want to take a look at the complete project, make sure you have installed the Articy importer for Unreal prior to opening the project. How to do that, we will see a bit later in this lesson. To use the course demo projects, there are two prerequisites. First, and it kind of goes without saying, you need the Unreal Engine installed. At the time of recording, I'm working with Unreal 5.0.3. Any newer version that has come out in the meantime shouldn't be an issue. For Unreal 4 users, 4.27 is the minimal required version, and please make sure to download the Unreal 4 project version. And secondly, you need Visual Studio installed as well. You can find a link in the video description on how to install Visual Studio correctly for Unreal, in case you have not done so already. After downloading the project package, links for that of course can also be found in the video description, unzip the archive to a location of your choosing. As I have multiple engine versions installed, I quickly check with a right-click on the uproject file and switch Unreal Engine version if the correct version is selected as default to start. If you only have a single version installed matching the project version, you can skip this. Then launch with a double-click. A dialog box opens up asking to rebuild modules. To keep the file size as small as possible when preparing the course material, we removed all binaries from the archive. As the Articy importer requires a C++ project, Unreal needs to compile and build the project before we are able to use it. Confirm with OK. Now we have to wait patiently for a bit. Unreal is doing its thing in the background without giving us any visual confirmation. At least that's the case with Unreal 5. Unreal 4 displays a progress bar. After some time, the editor starts loading, which, depending on your machine, might take another couple of minutes. When the editor opens, the project is ready to use. And that means we can finally dive in with the Unreal Base project. We keep the project as simple as possible to not distract from its main focus, to show how the implementation of the Articy importer works. Basically, we used Unreal's third-person template as the foundation for our project. As mentioned earlier, please note that even if we are only going to work with blueprints, to be able to use the Articy importer, the project needs to be a C++ project. But don't worry, if you have an existing blueprint-only project you'd like to use with Articy, it can be easily converted to work with C++ as well. You can find a link of how to do that in the video description. Everything that is important to the series and where we are going to make edits and updates is placed in the underscore demo folder. The other folders we can see in the content browser are part of the default Unreal template and are not relevant for the scope of this series. When we play the level, we can move the player character and interact with the NPCs. Interacting opens up the dialog UI. Let's take a look at the objects used in our little demo scene, starting with the demo game mode, which is located in the Blueprints folder. The game mode class traditionally manages all the relevant information about the default classes of the game, player, game state, HUD, etc. And it is easy to get access to it from everywhere in the game. In addition, the game mode is in charge to spawn all actors in the game, so it's created at runtime before the player and all other actors. As we created a C++ project, we are not able to use the default game mode with blueprint nodes. We use a game mode blueprint directly derived from game mode base and configured the project properties accordingly. If you create a new game mode in your project, it is important to set it as a default game mode in the project settings. This happens in the Maps and Modes tab. If you are in the Maps and Mode settings, make sure to also set the correct default Pawn class for this new game mode. And as game mode override in the World settings. The Demo game mode is responsible to create the HUD when the game starts. It also contains the functions to start and end the dialogue. And as soon as the Articy importer comes into play, the game mode will get even more responsibility. The player character blueprint is a child class of the default third-person character. The entire movement comes from the parent class. What we added is mainly an interaction check based on a trace. If the trace encounters an overlapping object, it checks if it implements the interact interface. If this is the case, an interaction prompt is displayed and the player can use the interaction key. The interact interface is implemented on the NPC blueprint. Here we call the play dialog function if an interaction took place. As mentioned earlier, play dialog and end dialog are implemented inside the demo game mode class. Play dialog removes the control from the player and makes the dialog widget visible. End dialog sets the widget to hidden and returns control to the player. Currently, end dialog only gets called when we click the red button in the dialog UI. Later, we will call it at the end of a conversation. This was a quick rundown of the blueprints in the current project state. If you want to check them or the functions out in more detail, download the project material and open the Unreal Base project. Now, we will install the Articy importer for Unreal in preparation for the next tutorial steps. There are two ways to get the importer: a project-based plugin version from GitHub and an engine-based version from the marketplace. They are identical in functionality. We will install the importer from the marketplace. The GitHub version we really only recommend if you want to contribute or plan to tweak the plugin code itself for your own needs or pipeline. I close the project and go to the marketplace tab in the launcher. Here I search for Articy and get the importer as a result. If you haven't used the importer before, you will see these options: Free and Add to Cart, which lets you acquire the plugin and add it to your vault. After a moment, the button will change and you can now install the importer to the engine. In case you already got the plugin earlier, you can also find it in the vault inside the library tab and install it from here. To confirm the installation, we can click Install plugins below the engine version and can see that the Articy importer is now listed here. Great, we can reopen the project now. Select Edit plugins. Inside Install plugins, I can easily spot the Articy importer and enable it. After enabling the importer, the window will prompt you to restart the editor. Please do so to activate the importer for your project. When the editor restarts, it might prompt you to rebuild missing DLL files for the importer, which you should confirm in this case. This can take a bit depending on the size of the project and the power of your computer. But once finished, the Unreal Editor should be back up again. Now we switch over to our Articy project. In case you have not yet prepared the project from the course material, extract the file to a location of your choosing. Then select Open from File from the Articy welcome screen. Navigate to the project location, open the folder, select the project info file and click Open. Now the project opens and will also be added to the project selection in the welcome screen. Within the project, we find two branching dialogs, which we will properly display in the Unreal project at the end of the series, and two test dialogs, which we will use for the implementation steps we are going to take. But first, we need to get the data from Articy Draft to Unreal. That part is easy. Click the main menu bubble and select Export. Choose Unreal from the list. If your project grows, you might want to split the export into separate packages that can be loaded at runtime as needed. But for this small project, we stick with exporting the entire project. You can find a link to more information about rule sets in the video description. Select the content folder of the Unreal project as the export folder and click OK. The export runs through and we can switch back to Unreal. Here an info window popped up asking us to confirm changes to some source content files. Click Import. Another pop-up appears informing us that an Articy runtime reference was not found. No need to worry, as this is the first time we import any Articy data, this is the absolute normal process. It is important that you select Yes here, to have the reference added automatically. If you select No, the process continues without touching the Unreal build tool files, meaning you would have to add the Articy runtime manually for the importer to work. Now some C++ code gets compiled, which depending on your machine might take a couple of minutes. If we look at our content browser now, we can see that an Articy content folder was created, as well as the actual export file on the content level. In the Articy content folder, you can find all Unreal objects that were generated from the imported database, as well as all assets that you exported from the Articy project. In case an automatic import should fail, you can always use the manual import options, which can be accessed via Settings, Articy Importer. We have arrived at the end of this first lesson. We looked at the Unreal project we will use throughout the series, installed the Articy importer from the marketplace, and exported data from Articy Draft and imported it to the Unreal project. In the next lesson, we will start using this data and begin working on a dialog system to display a first dialog line with speaker name and a custom dialog UI. See you there!